Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Kurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 23rd of April. Indian Foreign Minister meets a Chinese President in Beijing to boost bilateral ties. Death toll rises to at least 57 in Kabul suicide bombing. And India bags 10 gold medals in South Asian Judo Championship in Nepal. And now for all the details, Indian Foreign Minister Sushma Swaraj on Monday held talks with Chinese President Xi Jinping in Beijing to boost bilateral ties. Swaraj, who is on a four-day visit to China, is scheduled to attend the crucial Shanghai Cooperation Organization meeting on Tuesday.
Indian Foreign Minister Sushma Swaraj on Monday met China's President Xi Jinping ahead of the SCO Foreign Ministers meeting in Beijing. Swaraj is due to attend the Shanghai Cooperation Organization or SCO meeting scheduled for Tuesday in Beijing. Participants will exchange views on SCO cooperation as well as major international and regional issues during the meet. The Indian Foreign Minister, who is on a four-day visit to China, also called on Chinese Vice President Wang Qishan on Monday to boost bilateral ties. Earlier in the day, Swaraj addressed a gathering on the role of language in further strengthening ties between New Delhi and Beijing.
क्या जिस तरह से भारत और चीन के बीच संबंध प्रगाढ़ हो रहे हैं, व्यापार बढ़ रहा है, अंतर्राष्ट्रीय मंचों पर हम काम कर रहे हैं इकट्ठे, उसमें ये और भी ज़्यादा ज़रूरी हो गया है कि आप हिंदी सीखें और हिंदुस्तानी चीनी सीखें. ताकि जब वो यहाँ आए तो उन्हें भाषांतरकार की जरूरत न पड़े, जब आप वहाँ जाएं तो आपको भाषांतरकार की जरूरत न पड़े.
Swaraj's visit comes ahead of Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi's scheduled visit to China later this week. Efforts at rapprochement have gathered pace following a testing year in ties between the two giant neighbors.
Moving on, despite pressure from security officials, a massive rally was held on Sunday by a Pashtun rights group in Pakistan's Lahore city against human rights violations inflicted upon the community. Pashtuns have long claimed they have been targets of military operations, ethnic stereotyping and abductions by the Pakistani forces.
An ethnic Pashtun rights group drew a huge crowd to a rally in Pakistan's Lahore city on Sunday, despite pressure from security officials to call off the event focusing on human rights violations in areas bordering Afghanistan. The rights group Pashtun Tahaffuz Movement during the rally criticized the country's powerful military and its actions in federally administered tribal areas or Fatah. The north and south Waziristan areas of Fatah were the site of large military operations in 2009 and 2014 after the Pakistani Taliban took control of swaths of territory in the region.
Pakistan ke aain mein article 19 hai ke logon ko izhar rai ki azadi hai. Pakistan ke article 6 mein hai ke jo aain ko sabotage kare wo wazeh zadar hai.
This comes after earlier this month a massive rally was held by the group in Pakistan's Peshawar city against the Pakistani state-sponsored terrorism. Pashtuns have long blamed that they have been targets of military operations, ethnic stereotyping and abductions by the Pakistani security forces. They accuse that Pakistan army continues to function along with militant groups and indiscriminately uses force against innocent Pashtuns.
In news from Afghanistan, death toll rose to at least 57 on Monday in Afghanistan's Kabul suicide blast. The incident occurred after a bomber set off explosives at a voter registration center in a local school while the staff was distributing registration IDs on Sunday.
The death toll from a suicide blast in Afghan capital Kabul jumped to at least 57 on Monday, and witnesses said the victims included women, children, as well as police officers.
blew himself up.
The incident occurred on Sunday after a suicide bomber detonated explosives outside a center where dozens of people had been waiting to get registration IDs. In addition to the 57 killed, more than 100 people were wounded who are now fighting for their lives in the hospital. Ahead of the parliamentary and district council polls to be held in October, more than 7,000 voter centers have been set up across Afghanistan to handle about 10 million registrations. But there have already been at least three attacks on such centers since voter registration got underway earlier this month. Militant group Islamic State claimed responsibility for Sunday's attack.
In news from Nepal, Nepal's Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli on Sunday said he had spoken with Indian and Pakistani leaders to restart the stalled SAARC process. The 19th SAARC summit to be held in Pakistan has been put on hold for the past 2 years due to strained ties between New Delhi and Islamabad.
Nepal's Premier KP Sharma Oli on Sunday said he had spoken with Indian and Pakistani leaders to restart the stalled SAARC process. The 19th SAARC summit to be held in Pakistan has been put on hold for the past 2 years due to strained ties between India and Pakistan. While addressing an event in Kathmandu, Premier Oli said building friendly relations based on mutual understanding, cooperation and collaboration among SAARC member states is essential for peace and prosperity in the region. A month after Oli joined the office, his Pakistani counterpart Shahid Khakan Abbasi visited the Himalayan nation in March and agreed to revive the stalled SAARC process. During his visit to India early this month, Oli also discussed about the need to resume the SAARC process. The Nepalese leader, during his three-day trip, held discussions with top Indian leadership, including Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
More news from Nepal. India bagged a total of 10 gold medals during the South Asian Judo Championship held in Nepal. The three-day championship, which started on Saturday, witnessed participation from various South Asian countries, including Pakistan and Bangladesh.
India has bagged a total of 10 gold medals in the 8th edition of the South Asian Judo Championship being held in Nepal. Out of the 14 gold medals of the championship, India won over 10, with all 7 medals contested under women's single categories and rest under men's single categories. The rest of the 4 gold medals were won by Nepal and Pakistan, 2 each.
बहुत खुशी हो रही है बहुत हैप्पी हूं कि गोल्ड मेडल जीत के जा रही हूं इंडिया के लिए इंडिया के नाम रोशन करके लेके जा रही हूं तो बहुत खुशी हो रही है मुझे.
The three-day championship, which began on Saturday, besides the host Nepal, witnessed participation from many South Asian nations, including Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Pakistan and Sri Lanka. Pakistan, standing third in the list, won 2 gold, 3 silver and 3 bronze medals.
Tibetan spiritual leader Dalai Lama on Monday imparted spiritual lessons to the management students in Indian capital New Delhi. He said changes need to be done in the modern education system, which has become too materialistic.
Tibetan spiritual leader Dalai Lama on Monday said that the modern education system is too much materialistic and that needs to be changed. Dalai Lama made the remarks while delivering a convocation lecture at a management institute in Indian capital, New Delhi. He also spoke on the need to revive and regain the lost spiritual and cultural heritage in India.
It is essential. Existing education, very much oriented about material value. So through that education, eventually we create materialistic life. Materialistic culture, materialistic society. I think now that must change if we want happy humanity.
Dalai Lama, who won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1989, fled into exile in India in 1959 after an abortive uprising against Chinese rule. He has since lived mostly in Dharamshala in the northern province of Himachal Pradesh.
A week-long rugby training camp is ongoing in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province. Renowned Sri Lankan coach Ronnie Ibrahim has been called in especially to introduce new skills to rugby enthusiasts for international levels.
A rugby training camp has been organized in Srinagar city of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province in a bid to popularize the game in far-flung areas. Jammu and Kashmir Rugby Association called in the services of famous coach Roni Ibrahim from Sri Lanka and a couple of players from the Indian national rugby team. The week-long camp is being held to impart training to as many as 52 players of the valley.
जी हमें बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है मतलब इंटरनेशनल स्टैंडर्ड जो हम लोगों को समझ आ रहा है मतलब नई नई चीजें स्किल्स हमें आ रहे हैं नई नई गेम्स दिखा रहे हैं हम लोगों को खेलना जो हम लोगों को पहले इंट्रोड्यूस नहीं हुई थी यहां पे स्पेशली रग्बी जो हम लोगों को चीजें मतलब यहां पे जो चीजें आ रही है
Aspirants of the sport are learning new skills after getting exposed to international standards of the game which they had not experienced before
उन्होंने फॉरेन से कुछ एक टाइप है उनका जिनसे उन्होंने फॉरेन कोचेस फ्रॉम श्रीलंका मंगाए हैं अभी मिस्टर रोनी ही यूज्ड टू बी एन इंडियन फॉर्मर कोच एज वेल तो अभी यहां पे आए हुए हैं और उनके कई सारे साथी आए नेशनल प्लेयर्स आए उनके
फॉर अ कंट्री व्हिच गिव रग्बी वन ऑफ इट्स ओल्डेस्ट ट्रॉफीज द कलकत्ता कप द स्पोर्ट कुड नेवर बिकम पॉपुलर इन इंडिया हाउएवर नाउ मेनी आर एम्ब्रेसिंग द कॉन्टेक्ट स्पोर्ट इन एन अदरवाइज क्रिकेट क्रेजी कंट्री
Scores of devotees thronged a holy Sikh shrine golden temple in India's northern Amritsar city on Sunday to celebrate the birth anniversary of an 18th century Sikh warrior. A procession was taken out by the authorities which started from the Sikh shrine and went around the city with the devotees.
Devotees thronged the golden temple, the holiest shrine of Sikhism in India's northern Amritsar city on Sunday to celebrate the birth anniversary of Jassa Singh Ahluwalia, a prominent Sikh leader and warrior. A procession was taken out by the authorities which started from the Sikh shrine and went around the city with devotees. As part of the procession, Guru Granth Sahib, the holy scripture, was brought out of the golden temple in a flower-decked palanquin.
ਇਹ ਨਗਰ ਕੀਰਤਨ ਅਕਾਲ ਤਖਤ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਤੋਂ ਅਰਦਾਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਪੰਜ ਪਿਆਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਅਗਵਾਈ 'ਚ ਗੁਰੂ ਗ੍ਰੰਥ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੀ ਛਤਰਛਾਇਆ 'ਚ ਸੋ ਕੇ ਹਰ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਹਰਿਆਣਾ 'ਚੋਂ 3 ਦਿਨ ਲਗਾ ਕੇ ਦਿੱਲੀ ਪਹੁੰਚੇਗਾ
The procession saw young children perform Gatka, a Sikh martial art and demonstrate sword fighting skills among other things. The celebrations will next reach India's capital New Delhi on April 26 after traversing through northern Punjab and Haryana provinces where it will culminate.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Indian Foreign Minister meets a Chinese president in Beijing to boost bilateral ties. Death toll rises to at least 57 in Kabul suicide bombing. And India bags 10 gold medals in South Asian Judo Championship in Nepal. Now viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/southasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @southasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.